tell us a story."
"Tell us a story," said the young ones to the old lady.
"Yes, tell us a story that will make us happy."
"Happiness comes from inside you, my child, as you already know. I can tell you a story that will help you to recognize the truth."
"Ooh," came their reply, which was an open invitation to entertain and educate, to tell a tale.
"Are you sure you don't want me to dance?" she inquired.
"Old lady, you're going to break a hip. Don't dance us a story."
"Shall I sing it then?"
"Old lady, your voice isn't what it once was. Don't sing us a story."
"I'll tell you with pictures and colors and shapes."
"Yes, old lady, tell us a story with pictures and shapes."
She began.
"And recognizing a truth," she said, "ask, is it true all the time? Is it kind?
Even an uncomfortable truth is kind."
They looked at each other, nodded their agreement.
"Everything that was good in the past is not good now. Everything that was right and true in the past is not necessarily true now."
She looked at their bright faces and warned, "People tell lies."
The young ones were astounded.
"Oh my," they responded.
"Yes," she said, "like Santa, remember?"
The young people nodded and agreed among themselves that the old lady was making a solid point.
The old lady started. "The grown-ups don't want me to tell you. I shall, though, because I love you all." She took a deep breath and began her story.
"It is the truth that eggs, bunnies, and ham have nothing to do with Easter. Besides Jesus not being born in December, think, what does a tree with lights have to do with his birth?
A tool you can use to open your mind, that means to think outside the box of popular opinion. Think. Not with common sense, but uncommon, upside-down, kaleidoscope perspective."
The young ones listened intently as she continued. "The biggest truth is Genesis 1:29. The government is still perpetuating lies. It's just a plant put here for you," she pointed at them. "All of us. Those who suffer from AIDS, PTSD, and even cancer. WWJD.
One boy spoke up.
"Old lady, what about when the Bible says that man shall not lay with man? What about that?"
"Good thinking, my son," she smiled, a gleam in her eye.
"Did you know that the Bible also says that women who are bleeding after childbirth cannot touch certain things?"
"With this new information, what have you learned?"
The boy thought for a moment, then said, "Change happens?"
The old lady nodded, "Very good.
And how about knowledge happens when it is sought?"
She became serious and told them,
"Ask questions. Question authority."
A girl questioned,
"What about love your neighbor as yourself? What about that one?"
The old lady seemed to be thinking and then answered, "Ask, who will it hurt, and then act. Do you think you can do that?"
The children looked at each other and talked among themselves, then answered in unison,
"Yes, we can,
and so can you."
Smiling faces show no traces of the evil that lurks within.
Can you grin?
Smiling faces, sometimes they don't tell the truth. Smiling faces tell